Hello, this is MicroJ101, and in this video I'm going to show you how to make a really simple and cheap and easy to make propane burner. Alright, so the main thing you're going to need for this project is a source of fuel. I'm going to be using this blowtorch. So this is a propane bottle with a blowtorch adapter on it. You could use natural gas. I used natural gas in another video to power my boiler for my steam engine. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to remove the burner assembly. So you need to remove the barrel and the mixing chamber. So first let me demonstrate how big the flame will be on your blowtorch. Depending on how big the flame is on your blowtorch, that's going to govern how big you can get a flame on here, because it's basically going to be this flame except spread out over this distance here of your how many holes you have. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to take the burner barrel off of here. So just screw this off, and this is pretty standard blowtorch. So you screw this part off. This mixes, it sucks in air through these little holes here and then mixes it with the propane and then burns it. So right in the end here, there is something called an orifice, which is a really small hole. It's basically a nozzle that shoots the propane out at a high velocity, and that also kind of sucks in air with it through these holes and mixes it in and then burns it. So you could remove the orifice that should screw out on most blowtorches, and then you could get even more propane if you want to. But it'll empty your propane tank real fast, and then you don't have that high velocity to help move air in as well. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to take this and you're just going to put that in your copper pipe. So what I use for my burner is a simple half-inch copper pipe. This is just a bit of scrap. I hammered over the end with a hammer, and then so that you could use an end cap on the end if you wanted to, and then drill a bunch of holes in it of your desired size. I found that these holes were actually too big, because sometimes with the amount of gas I was burning, the flame would get so close that it would actually ignite the gas inside, make a pop sound, and then put out the flame. So that was kind of annoying. So I switched to smaller holes, and they work a lot better. So now what you're going to need to do is actually adjust how much air is going in with it. This design here actually sucks in way too much air, and you can't get it to light. So if I turn on the gas here, it's on full. As you can see, if I try to light it, it's not lighting. It just kind of blows out. That's because there's too much air going in and not enough fuel. So what you need to do is just plug it up. You could make a valve or something to do this. I'm just using a bit of paper towel to plug it up. So now there's going to be less oxygen going in. Now it'll light perfectly. But actually, as you can see, there's a bit of a yellow flame there. That means that there's not enough oxygen. So if you have a yellow flame, not enough oxygen, you need to open it up a little bit, because you want a blue flame, a nice crisp blue flame. So right like that, that's a nice flame there. This is too much oxygen. If the flames are starting to lift off like that, there's too much oxygen. So you want a flame just about like that. Well, it's a little too much. Right like that. You want the flame like that. That'll give you a nice, hot, clean burn. You won't get carbon monoxide. If you have too much or too little oxygen, you might get carbon monoxide or other things like that. But this is a nice, hot flame. You could boil water with this, do whatever you want to. It's really simple. Watch my other videos on the boiler. This is actually another design of a burner tube. This one is for this boiler here. This one is made out of 3/4-inch stainless steel pipe, smashed over the end, and then cut a bunch of slots in with a hacksaw, and then I have this screen to go over it to disperse the flame more. I show that in another video. So, but yeah, that's a really simple burner. You can make it in like 5 minutes, and boil some water. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching.